So today we are going to perform next practical. The title of this practical is the head loss due to sudden expansion. So we have to analyze what is the effect of head loss when the pipe is suddenly expand. So you can see taping 9 and 10. Here is occurring sudden expansion from 9 to 10. The diameter of 9 is less than the diameter of taping 10. So what are the diameters? So you can see sudden enlargement 13.6 millimeter and 26.2 millimeter. That is D1 and that is the D2. So diameter is less implies that the area is less. So area is less, according to equation of continuity, you can say velocity is less and vice versa.
One valve is fully open and other two valves are fully closed. So wait until all the air is removed.
So here is our table for calculation for sudden expansion. So diameter D1 is 13.6 millimeter and D2 26.2 millimeter. And the ratio is 0.51. From user guide, the ratio of diameter is vary from 0 to 1. So in our case, the ratio is 0.5. So it is round about 0.4 and 0.6 between these two. So the K values are given against the ratio of diameters. By interpolation method, we have calculated KL value. From diameter D1, we have calculated area A1 and area A2. So first column of our table is flow rate as usual, and upstream reading, downstream reading and difference of both. So next, the velocities column. You know that the velocity will be changed because of area is changed. So U1 upstream velocity and downstream velocity is U2, and the head loss due to velocity change, that is HU equal to U1 square divided by 2G minus U2 square divided by 2G, that is in meter. And next column is the square of difference of both velocities, so that is the velocity head. And the second last column is HL, that is our head loss, is equal to KL into square or difference of both the velocities divided by 2G, that is the velocity head. So that is our head loss. And the last column is the negative of difference of head loss due to velocity and the head loss due to pressure.
So now our discharge is stable, and now I am connecting the loops with our taping 9 and 10. So now closing the valve, wait until all the bubbles of air are removed. Closed, and both tubes must have the same level. So you can see now it's almost level. So I am going to open this valve. 50% is open. So now it is stable, and you can see upstream reading is less and the downstream reading is more. So our upstream reading is, you can see, 877 millimeter, and downstream reading, that is high, that is 1098 millimeter, 225, that is 0.00225 cubic meter per second. Next, our discharge is stable and 0.199. So 0.0. And the piezometric readings, upstream reading 907 millimeter,
and downstream reading that is high 1087. So next discharge is 0.168. And upstream reading is 946. Downstream reading 1075. Next discharge is 0.061. 0.00061. Our upstream reading is now 1037, and downstream reading 1053. So these are the calculation for the pipe having sudden expansion. So first column flow rate we have measured from hydraulic bench and upstream and downstream reading from piezometric tubes. So we simply take difference of both, and this is the U1 and U2. Two columns are the upstream and downstream velocities. So how we calculated upstream velocity U1, that is U1 is equal to Q divided by A1. So by using area and discharge we have calculated upstream velocities and also downstream velocities. So head loss due to velocity change, that is U2 square divided by 2G minus U1 square divided by 2G. So you can see these values are negative. So we have calculated head loss due to velocity change, and the next column is the square of difference of velocity head, and the last column is head loss. So we used KL value U1, U2 and gravitational acceleration, so calculated head loss. And last column, the negative or difference of pressure head and velocity head. So these values are also in negative.